President, moment ago I had a discussion with you about a piece of legislation that I filed. And this is not a partisan piece of legislation. Senate Bill 147 that is co-sponsored with Senator Perry. A companion bill was filed by Representative John Bland, Representative Chris Fugit, and some others in the chamber. I think also the Senator Carter is co-sponsoring this bill. In Eastern Kentucky, the region that has basically powered this Commonwealth and helped fuel this nation through not only the Great Depression, through the period of industrial development, economic prosperity that made the United States a superpower. And unfortunately, due to the situation facing our region with the loss of population and economic circumstances facing our region, the Public Service Commission a few years ago issued an order that allowed Kentucky Power to close the Big Sandy Power Plant in Louisiana. And Representative Rocky Atkins and myself wrote letters of protest and we worked to make sure that Public Service Commission knew how detrimental that we failed closing the Big Sandy Power Plant would be. When I say closing it, for all intents and purposes, it was closed. There were two coal-fired generators. One was allowed to be turned down and one was allowed to be converted to natural gas. Now, before some people want to say that it was a war on coal or whatever led to this, I don't know that that's quite accurate. What the Public Service Commission allowed Kentucky Power to do was it allowed Kentucky Power to buy a power plant for an affiliated company that already owns. It called the Mitchell Power Plant that already owns in West Virginia. It passed on to the ratepayers all the costs of converting one burner, Louis, to natural gas. It passed on the cost of tearing down the other burner for the ratepayers. And at the time that this had taken place, there were a lot of things added to the power bill, like a retirement rider for the Big Sandy Power Plant, demand side management fees for various programs, and the economic development surcharge. Now, let me tell you what happened. Kentucky Power took that money that it generated from that economic development rider.
Are you talking about East Kentucky Power or American Electric?
American Electric Power.
Okay, Kentucky Power.
Okay. It is Kentucky Power. Kentucky Power is a subsidiary of American Electric Power. AEP is a parent company. And Kentucky Power essentially went around handing out checks to different organizations under the guise of economic development. The one thing about that, though, is that wasn't their money. That was the ratepayers' money. And in fact, I have been to at least one groundbreaking for a business there in Eastern Kentucky this year where Kentucky Power was handing out a check. Now, Mr. President, if you want me to check the book, I'm going to run out and share the contributions out. At least when people looked at the check, they would see your name on it. Well, when Kentucky Power's been wanted out handing out these checks, it's got their name on it, but it's not been their money. It's money that's been generated from ratepayers. And then, as I scroll through Facebook one night, most of you know I love aviation, and I see a executive with Kentucky Power at the Paris, France Air Show delegation. And that company was the Paris Air Show under the guise of economic development. Now, keep in mind that we only have one commercial airport in that region. It's Huntington Tri-State Airport in West Virginia, just across the river from Nashville. Now, I appreciate the fact that Kentucky Power wants to see economic development in Eastern Kentucky. The problem is it should be done with the ratepayers' money in an area where many people are struggling to make ends meet. And I would encourage members of the Senate to go on my Facebook page with Senator Perry's and look at the bills that some people are submitting. Residential power bills higher than anywhere else in Kentucky. $1,300, $900, $1,100. I even had a gentleman who sent me a message this week. A power bill is $1,800. Now, for those of you who don't live in the same area served by Kentucky Power, like the Senator Perry and myself, and Senator Carter, you probably can't put that in perspective. But you have an area under the last PSC ruling, Kentucky Power's getting a 9.7% return. Now think about that. They have a monopoly. For those of you in business, none of us who have a business, for that matter, have a guaranteed profitability, he said, for investor-owned utilities. And under U.S. Supreme Court decisions, they're entitled to a reasonable return on their investment. But let me say this. I feel, and a lot of other people feel, that a guaranteed 9.7% return on investment in the hard economic times facing Eastern Kentucky is unconscionable. And what Senate Bill 147 does is very simple. It says that the Public Service Commission finds that the region is economically distressed, as defined in the federal law, that the profit that they're guaranteed did not exceed 6%. Most of them would think that's reasonable. Keep in mind, if people are having to make life or death decisions, we just had an extremely cold period of time in Eastern Kentucky. And when you have people who literally are having to make decisions about whether they pay their power bill or whether they buy food or medicine or pay their other bills, this is not something I am saying you're making up. This is factual. And it has affected tens of thousands of people in Eastern Kentucky. And this is a bipartisan bill, and I'm calling on the Senator from Madison to have hearings on this. Just let me throw something out at you. From now until the session's over, I'm going to try to give some facts about Kentucky Power. Just something, a little food for thought. A couple years ago, I took my son over to the Greenbrier class and took practice from him. I bought tickets. I drove him over there. And guess what I see? Kentucky Power's then president was playing the program. Now, I believe it cost about $25,000 to play the program. Another little interesting fact. American Electric Power has 9 pilots on the payroll. 9. And in this last rate case, when the filings were submitted, the information I've been given was that $600,000 of the cost to operate their aviation section, right, their aviation department, $600,000 of that was allocated to the ratepayers in the Kentucky Power District. $600,000 for aviation costs. Now, it is only about a 4-hour drive from Pikeville to Columbus. And I'm trying to figure out how you can spend $600,000 flying around AEP service, or Kentucky Power Service Area, which is pretty much Eastern Kentucky. But think about it, $600,000. The way that investor-owned utilities are allowed to recoup their profits, the way they're allowed to pay their expenses, pass their expenses on to the ratepayers, is unconscionable. Many of you may not realize this, but investor-owned utilities are even able to pass their tax liability on to the ratepayers. Everything that they spend is passed on. So in reality, when you say a reasonable return on their investment, it's really not their investment. It's a reasonable return on the ratepayers' money that pays essentially for everything they spend. And I'm calling on the members to join me in Senator Perry in giving a fair hearing to Senate Bill 147. The people of Eastern Kentucky simply cannot absorb the cost of electric power rates that they're seeing. And it is a huge impediment to economic development. Now, as we've heard, some of the budget proposals that have shifted various fees, charges, expenses to our local boards of education, these costs are being borne by our local schools. The power rules for some of these school districts has increased dramatically. The power bills for municipal and county governments have increased dramatically. And that creates an additional burden on the taxpayers, who in many Eastern Kentucky counties, Mr. President, have seen their property taxes increased by double digits over the last year. So this is an issue that I'm going to bring to the attention of the members. I suspect Senator Perry may want to address this, because this is something that is literally a matter of life or death for my constituents, Senator Carr's constituents, and Senator Perry's constituents. Thank you, Mr. President.